threat of nuclear war looms over us all. Powerful countries on Earth have huge stockpiles of nuclear weapons that they will hopefully never use. But one has to wonder, if they were forced to, how many nuclear weapons would it take to end humanity? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see next. There are over 17,000 nuclear weapons in the world that we know of, and they are possessed by only 9 countries. And out of those 9 countries, only 2 possess the vast majority of nuclear weapons on this planet, the United States and Russia. The fact is, if the world is forced into a nuclear conflict, very few nuclear weapons would be needed to cause serious damage to the environment, our infrastructure, and even global human extinction. When World War II ended, the world was shocked by the atomic bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The scientists who developed the atomic bombs contemplated how many nuclear weapons it would take to end humanity. According to a recently declassified document shared by nuclear historian Alex Wellerstein, the scientists at the Los Alamos Laboratory decided that it would require somewhere between 10 to 100 super nukes to end humanity, as in a hydrogen bomb. And this was decided in the year 1945, way before nuclear weapons and multi-stage weapons were even developed. It was believed in the 1980s that a global nuclear war could result in the planet being uninhabitable, but now scientists are certain that even a regional war could cause immense devastation and suffering across the globe. According to the scientific journal Earth's Future, even a war that only took place on one side of the planet, let's say in Asia, would be extremely problematic for someone living on the opposite side of the planet. Nuclear detonations would create firestorms, and those firestorms would create black soot. A lot of it, some 5 million tons. That black soot would end up in our atmosphere, our oceans, and drinking water. The soot that goes into the atmosphere would block out the sunlight, causing global temperatures to drop. On average, we would see a drop of 3 degrees Fahrenheit, with most of North America experiencing a 4 to 10 degree colder winter. This would cause a dramatic initial loss of plant life. Frost would cover the earth and would shorten the growing seasons by at least a month. This decrease in temperature of the earth could last anywhere between a decade to as long as 25 years. That's according to Michael Millis, an atmospheric scientist at the National Center for Atmospheric Research. So maybe you're thinking, nuclear winter might not be so bad. Canadians survive in ridiculously cold winter, so can everyone else. Other than causing global temperatures to drop, there's also another danger. On the flip side, deploying nuclear weapons could affect our ozone layer. It is estimated that there could be an 80% increase in the sun's radiation after the ash would heat up the stratosphere and accelerate the chemical reactions that destroy the ozone layer. This, combined with the soot and a drop in global temperature, would destroy ecosystems all over the globe, on the land and in the sea. Humans as well as other life forms get their food from those ecosystems. Without it, a global famine is almost certainly inevitable, especially in poor countries. In addition to black soot, nuclear detonations would create radioactive fallout that would be spread across the globe through the atmosphere. These poisons would cause rates of cancer to skyrocket, as well as birth defects and genetic anomalies. The fears about the dangers of nuclear fallout entering the atmosphere are no joke. They're the reason why nuclear weapons are no longer tested above ground. The last time a nuclear weapon was used in war, it was 1945. Let's hope it stays that way. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre for Life's Biggest Questions. Don't forget to click the bell so you never miss an upload.